So from there on to another tech giant story, Facebook. I mean, there's a lot that's been happening with Facebook over the last week. So do you want to quickly do the highlights? And then
it's not been a good year for Facebook, or a good several years reputation wise. I just was reading an article in The Economist about how it's at a reputation tipping point. I think it has been for a while. You know, we had the whistleblower. Facebook was down. All of the Facebook properties were down on Monday. Then they're having the hearings in the States. Governments are sounding the alarms. This surveillance capitalism that Facebook employs, the algorithm, the secrecy, and all of that. There's just so much going on right now because they have such control over so much of our lives. Basically everyone, you know, everyone agrees there is a problem, but like getting consensus on the solution, I don't know how that's going to happen at all. What are you thinking about it all?
I mean, it's like, I'm thinking, what's the solution? Like this, what they're expecting Facebook to do and self-regulate on their own is obviously not working. So at what point does somebody step in? Where's the, some sort of regulation has to come into play on some of the stuff, right? And you know, with their big outage from last week where they had, what was it, about 8 or 9 hours that all of their properties were offline, and there was delicious little conspiracy theories about whether that had
I loved those,
with the whistleblower situation.
I'm sure some businesses, like it or not, like Facebook is how they're going to make their money. It's how they can advertise affordably, you know, reach their people. But I'm sure, again, like with a lot of people, it's just getting harder and harder to be okay with working with Facebook so much. So regardless of if they're going to have an outage again, I just think ethically, a lot of people are questioning and thinking like, oh, I don't want to keep all my eggs in this one Facebook basket. You know, so what's that solution, Susan? Like, if I'm a business who everything is on Facebook, I have the communities and, you know, I advertise on Facebook. My posts are basically like, you know what I mean? Like some people really do have everything on Facebook.
I think it's an opportunity to move. Obviously, I mean, I'm totally biased here because we think podcasting is the answer to everything. But that said, I think there's an opportunity to move some of that over to podcast form. A lot of people rely on Facebook groups and videos and lives in the Facebook or Instagram universe. And I think the easy first step is to think about how you can repurpose some of that into your own podcast, right? But that said, it also is your intellectual property, your infrastructure that sits in your website as well. So I think thinking about how you can repurpose things that you've created for those third-party channels. And it's not a one and done. It's not like I'm going to do this over 3 months and I'm finished. I think it takes a while.